Sin and Abyss Domine Misericordium to Domine Exaudiratione Mea. Domini sancti pater omnipotens et Deo, et pater et ne sanctum angelum tuum de celis, qui custodia fabia protegat, visita et credit in omnes habitabis in hoc habitaculo, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Thank you.
Gloria in excelsis Deo. Dominus vobis tuum. Sequentia sancti evangelii, secundum Luca.
Gloria tibi, Domine.
In illo tempore, dixit Jesus discipulus suos parvum haec, homiquid in eretives qui hepedic angelicum, et hic defamatus esse podilum, quasi displacet bone ipsios, et vocavit illum et illi, quid hoc adie deite, quid irrationes vivificationes tue, iam enum non poteres vivificare, et ad angelicus intra se, quid faciam quia dominus mes, afferat of me, vilificatione, fortere non valio, medicare erubisco, scia quid faciam, o come modus fuere vivificationes, recipit me in domus suas, convocatus itique singulus debitoribus dominus sui, dicebim prima, quando debes domino meo, et ili dixit, sentum cedas olie, dixit quaedi, accepit casianum tuum, et sed sita quiscribe quinquagenta, de in de ali dixi, tu vera quantus debes, quia sentum corus trici, et ili accepit literus tuus, escribe octoginta, et laudavit dominus filicum iniquitatis, quia prudenti faesset, quia filii huius saeculi prudentoris filius lucis, in generationis suae sunt, et ego vobis dico, facite vobis dominicus de memone iniquitatis, ocum deferitus recipit vos, interna tabernacula.
Notice this is the 8th Sunday after Pentecost. Please take home a copy of the bulletin and please read it. Father Limborn is in the confessional now. At the end of Mass, before the final hymn, we'll venerate the relic of St. Ignatius of Loyola, whose feast day it is today. St. Amata menu, Malaysian chicken, curry and rice, brioche burgers, chicken, parmigiana and fish and chips. Free ice cream and ice cream cones for children for the feast of St. Anne and St. Martha. Your prayers are asked for last week's visiting priest, Father Wynn, and his family. Father Wynn's mother died on Wednesday during Mass in the morning. So please pray for Marie Cecilia Wynn and Father Wynn and his family. Confirmation and First Holy Communion. Parents of children of those interested in making either their First Holy Communion or confirmation, please contact myself and fill in a form and get any catechetical materials needed. Date set for 1st of October in the bulletin. Further details in due course. More helpers are needed to live stream the daily Mass from St. Anne's to the whole world. So if you're able to help, please see me. Many people who cannot get to the Latin Mass or even Mass at all pray the Mass each day via St. Anne's YouTube channel. So any Sunday there could be at least 100 people praying the Mass at this very moment, and even more views throughout the day. So if you're able to help, please see me, and instructions on how to operate the equipment will be provided. St Anne's Mother's Group on Tuesday evening, the 2nd of August. St Anne's Entertainment Book, there's a special sale this weekend to purchase a 12-month entertainment membership this weekend and get 4 extra months for free, 16 months in total to use it. Details are in the bulletin. Also at the entrance is blessed St Anne's chaplets and prayer cards, also St Philomena booklets, and also a novena for the Assumption as well. So please take any of them if you're going to use them, the St Philomena novena or St Anne or the Our Lady's Assumption. And if possible, please place a donation in the box provided, or proceeds to go towards charitable purposes. Now, today's gospel is one of those parables which, of course, cannot be taken literally. It is obvious to everyone that our Lord is not recommending that we steal from our employer in order to curry favour with the customer, in order to expect money from them when we are in need. In the night office, St. Jerome, the translator of the Bible, said, "The Lord commends the unjust steward because he had done wisely, though wickedly. He is commending the steward for his prudence and certainly not for his dishonesty." Now, of course, this prudence of the steward can be imitated by all of us. As St. Paul said, we are all joint heirs with Christ. The inheritance from God the Father is a spiritual one. We lay up treasure in heaven, spiritual treasure, by using the spiritual goods of our common inheritance. And that, of course, is through the sacraments, confession, Holy Communion, and Holy Mass. But our Holy Catholic faith makes it possible to gain God's grace just about anywhere and at any time. We all have the gift of prayer, which we can use the assets belonging to God to adore him, thank him, express sorrow to him, and to petition him for our well-being. Now, this prayer can also be vocal or mental. No one around you need to be disturbed or even necessarily know that it is going on. As we know, the Mass and sacraments require us being somewhere at a specific place. But all of us can have time for vocal or mental prayer, whether we are even walking, driving, lawn mowing, or whatever we are doing are opportunities for spending our Master's assets for our own good. No doubt you can think of other ways as well. Now, recently I heard a woman saying that she was a Catholic whose husband had died recently, but she was not understanding why she should pray for him. She consulted someone in the church who said that prayer would help her husband to move on. It became obvious that the lady who claimed to be a Catholic had never been taught about heaven, hell, and purgatory, or may have talked about heaven, but never the other two. And this is not all that surprising, because one of the major heresies of the past 50 years is the heresy of universal salvation, that everyone goes to heaven, regardless of what they do. And this is something modernists like to quote all the time, that there's no need for any sacraments because everyone goes to heaven. But this really is just an old heresy way back 1500 years ago that went back to Origen of Alexandria and Gregory of Nyssa's time, who claimed that at some point in time, all of God's creatures, including evil men and devils, fallen angels, would be restored to grace and taken into heaven. This heresy, of course, clearly denies the justice of God. And this heresy was formally condemned at the Council of Constantinople in 543 AD. And you can read all about that in the Catholic Encyclopedia. Now, the twin realities of eternal punishment and eternal reward are graphically described by our Lord in St. Matthew's Gospel, where he describes the events to take place on the day of the Last Judgment, The wicked go into the eternal fire, and the good be gathered up into the barn of my heaven. So hell is very real, and our Lord tells us that evil men and fallen angels, devils, will go there. And in fact, our Lord is the one who spoke more about hell than anyone else in the Bible. Some people say, oh, the others talk about it, but it was our Lord himself that spoke more about hell than anything else, than anyone else. Now, this Catholic lady and others might still question, why then should I pray for the dead? And even more so, if hell is eternal, what good can any human effort do for souls condemned to hell? Now, to be sure, we cannot do anything for those in hell. But as we read in the Old Testament book of Maccabees, those Jewish men who battled to defend God's holy religion and his holy temple, that they sent silver to Jerusalem for sacrifice to be offered for the sins of the dead, because they knew that they would rise again and in God's service might be forgiven their sins, if the living ask God for the forgiveness of their fallen comrades. It is therefore a holy and wholesome thought to pray for the dead that they may be loosed from their sins. 2 Maccabees chapter 12. So as we know from the Catholic teaching of purgatory, even those sins forgiven during life may have punishments associated with them, and they may have to be satisfied in the world to come. For example, parents who forgive their child for hitting their cricket ball through the window might be forgiven for that sin. But of course, the window still has to be repaired. The effects of that sin still remain. And the sufferings of purgatory in some measure atone for the offences we have committed against God's dignity through sin in this world. But one might still ask, then how can prayer gain this forgiveness of sin or punishment? Well, through prayer we call upon the generosity of God, reminding him of all the good things done by in his honour by human beings, especially the saints, such as St. Ignatius of Loyola today, and most especially by his Blessed Mother. We are part of what is called the communion of saints, and we can expect their intercession on our behalf. Through Holy Mother the Church, we gain indulgences and offer masses for the poor souls, and God will always apply these graces according to his wisdom and mercy. So, for example's sake, if we had Mass for offered for someone who is already in heaven, well, the merits of that Mass are never wasted. They just get applied to the soul that needs it. And as we know, the souls in purgatory, the church suffering, cannot pray for themselves. But they too ultimately belong to the communion of saints and all have a right for prayers from us on their behalf. A particularly strong case in the case of a spouse or a relative or a friend, but a right at least in charity for all of us. And if we pray for them, we can call upon them when they are released from purgatory as very grateful saints of heaven when God releases them from purgatory. Let us pray that we will use God's graces and use God's merits for them and for us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Ghost.
Creator in unum Deum,
patrem omnipotentem, factorum genitus
Thank you.
Omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritum tuo.
Sursum gaudia. Gratias agamus, Domino Deo nostro.
Dio.
Egnimetius domesticum et salutare. Nos tibi semper dubique gratias agere. Dominus sanctipater omnipotens et Deus. Qui cum unigenito filio tuo, et Spiritus Sancto unus est Deus, unus Deus Domino. Non in singulitate personae, sed in unus Trinitate substantiae. Quod enim de tua gloria revelante te credimus, hoc de filio tuo, hoc de spiritui sancto, sine differentia discretionis sentimus, ut in confessione veri sepidenique deitatis, et in personas proprietas, et in essentia unitas, et in maestate adorator qualitas, quam laudan angeli aquae arcangeli, cervinque ex seraphim, qui nocton codidie una voce dicente. Sanctus, sanctus. Is that my mom was done last Saturday? Said it like so, said it was lost. Somebody lost it. Ambient a passion, as the more let him versus a red seal. Said angel versus a red seal. Lost it. 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 Lost it.
Novus quaeque peccatoribus. Omnia saecula saeculorum. Oremus bishop de solitaribus moniti, et divina institutione formati, adeemus dehitrere, pater noster qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum. Adveniat regnum tuum, via voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem. Omnia saecula saeculorum. Pax Domini sit semper, vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Domine non sunt ignus. Domine non sunt ignus. Domine non sunt ignus. Miserat vester omnipens de sedemispedatus vestis, pedigat vos et vita maternum. Indidentium ad pris in emissionem peccatorum vestrum, tibi vobis sumbens misicors somnus. Adjunus de adjicatola picata mundi. Domine non sundinus ad investite commands the town of the verbis of an animal. Domine non sundinus ad investite commands the town of the verbis of an animal. Domine non sundinus ad investite commands the town of the verbis of an animal. Thank you. Grazie Menis et Corpus Christi, Maesterium, Opius Extrema Porto Sentiamus Effectum, Per Dominum Nostrum Iesum Christum Filium Tuo, Qui Te Capivitat Regnat, In Unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Domina vobiscum.
Et tu spiritu tuo.
Benedicat vos omnipotens Dominus Vesca. Initium Sancti Evangelii Secundum Johannem. In principio verbum, verbum potam et Deus verbum, caret in principio potam. Omnipotens factus omnes, initium factum est, initium factum est, initium vita et vita lux omnes. Et lux intensus et tenem in comprendorum. Fiat omnes visitae, cum in nomine ratio hans, et ven testimonium, testimonium praet to lumine. Nomis cadam per lumine, non eo lux testimonium praet to lumine. Eo lux fere quae luminis omnum hominum venient mundum. In modo durat, in modo svactus es, in modo se in nocrucne, vidi in propter venit il suo mani in cepra. Quacquat em in cepra ne, in edit es, festana filius de firi. Iscrium mi es, green non ex inguinis nequeus, voluntanis nequeus, voluntade vire. Sed ex te nati sum. Et verbum cae factum est et habitavit in nobis. Et venimus gloriae quoque si ingenia patre. Panem gratiae et veritatis. Into Saint Siena, Saint Ignatius Loyola, liberat vos et omni malo, in nomine Patris, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Let us pray. Our glorious patriarch, Saint Ignatius, we humbly beseech thee, obtain for us from Almighty God, above all things else, deliverance from sin, which is the greatest of evils, and next from the scourges wherein the Lord chastises the sins of his people. May thine example enkindle in our hearts an effective desire to employ ourselves in labouring for the greater glory of God and for the good of our fellow men. Attain for us likewise from the loving heart of Jesus our Lord, that grace which is the crown of all graces, that is to say, the grace of final perseverance and everlasting happiness. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Saint Ignatius of Loyola,
pray for us.
Saint Ignatius of Loyola,
pray for us.
Saint Ignatius.